What is up, fellow patriots? Welcome to today's feature-length episode of Indoctrination of Children. Bum, bum, bum. Oh, we're twinners.
Insiders fighting for insiders. Time to stop. Insiders fighting for insiders. America first. Love the flow.
There, you probably have seen this. That footage in... Whoa.
Not again.
Let's not remember last time that happened. Here, just, yeah, put it more. You might have seen that footage of that in Texas. There was a gay bar, and they literally had these drag queens walking out in front of children. Like, they brought children in the
professional
bar.
Strippers.
This was a
professional drag queen strippers.
There was literally a poster on the wall that said, it's not going to lick itself.
Oh!
Can you imagine the backlash, though, if it gets you out of school? It's like, it's not going to lick itself!
They probably don't even know what they're talking about.
No, they probably don't. It's probably when a kid, like, is... saying slang dirty like a kid's at school and's like, that's what she said! Like, yeah. You know what that means? No, of course not!
They're asking their mom for a lollipop. It's not gonna lick itself!
What? Oh, lollipop! Oh, wow! Easy! Easy, son. I mean, daughter, I mean, non-binary.
Gets confusing nowadays.
Yeah, but this stripper, we're gonna show it in a few seconds, walked down the aisles with her freaking, like, butt hanging out, you know, like, very revealing clothing, nearly underwear. You got this man who thinks he's a woman.
Nothing acceptable for children.
No, not at all. And you have him walking down the hallway. There's even another picture I'm going to put right here. Let's put it right in front of Jack.
Aww.
Of this kid putting money in a stripper's panties.
Oh, I don't want that on my face.
No, it's on your face already.
Oh, no.
I'm going to make it fade. Watch this. Oh, yeah.
Boom.
Anyway, we are going to go through the footage of these strippers walking down the hallway for young children. You don't get that at Disney, like Winnie the Pooh walking around being like, hello, Mr. Child. Hey, I'm gay Pooh. All right, turn up the
volume. Well, I mean, there is a new horror movie for Winnie the Pooh, so that might be one of the scenes.
Dude, I totally watched that Winnie the Pooh.
Okay,
turn up ready? Is the sound on?
Yeah, but not too much. Right?
That's just making me uncomfortable. Little Red Riding Hood over here.
Mature content, by the way. So if there's any children,
what are these moves? What kid is gonna be like? What did you do? Like the teacher asked the class? What did you do your weekend? Oh, I went fishing with Grandpa. Oh, what did you do? I went to a gay bar and watched some tranny strip.
Oh.
Look at them do the splits, and the kids are like, "What the frick is happening?" I bet those parents dragged the kids out there.
Boom! Crush.
That isn't even a talented dance, though. Like, I could dance like that. I mean, you don't want me to, but... It's not talent. It honestly is not talent. Anyone could do that.
And everyone nowadays is saying how, like, awful the new social medias are, which they are. But this is the kind of crap that, like, TikTok has to show. So would you hand your kid a phone? Would you hand your 7-year-old kid a phone with TikTok that has half-naked people on it that are dancing? It doesn't make it any better if they're trans.
I'd rather hand them a Playboy magazine.
Back to the old days.
At least they'll get into girls. No! Don't take my words!
Cancel culture!
Cancel, just cancel stamp. Boom! Right in the face. No, but this is kind of sickening, though. And why is Texas, though, like, the most Republican
Texas
state?
Texas
has fallen apart. Like, they can't get their shiz together recently.
If I was Texas, I'd be out of there.
Vamanos. Adios, amigo. They kind of speak Spanish in Texas.
Get your cowboy butt out of there. All the cowboy rednecks are probably sick and tired.
No, I'd be
sick. Oh, that just gave me a flashback.
Here, I'll just hold it.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll have it on my...
But yeah, this is just... It's awful. It's...
No, but what kid goes into a... What kid wants to go into a gay bar, though, willingly? Like, what kid is like...
What kid even knows what a gay bar is?
Actually, yeah, what kids wants to, though, spend their free time in a gay bar? Like the kids in there, you see them in the footage, actually the trainees had them, like, get in the middle, and they walked him down the aisle. The first kid looks freaking terrified. Like, his face was like, Mom, I thought you said you'd take me to Red Lobster!
He's hunched over, and he's like pouting, and he's like, what am I doing here?
He looks like a broken man, non-binary man.
Oh, his life definitely changed after that moment.
No, he probably is not sleeping at night anymore. I wouldn't. Yeah, if some trainee grabbed my hand and walked down the hallway, like, do-do-do-do, and I'd be in the air, I'm like, oh my God.
I had some pretty bad dreams even getting ready for this episode watching these clips.
And also there's the trans birthday parties. They have trans showing up at their birthday parties.
Oh yeah, it's like, hey mommy, what did you get for my surprise party?
We got a clown, just kidding, a naked person!
It's a transgender stripper.
No, but what kid wants? That's sickening!
They're, like, there's just a, they're hitting the pinata. A friggin' trans stripper jumps out.
They grab on the rope.
Hey,
they grab on the rope and they're like, yeah!
They're like, hey kids, what's up? You want to learn about the world?
Stop shaking your freaking A at me and let me open my dang presents!
This is your present.
Oh my frick! Mom, what did you do with your money? No wonder we're poor and bet on horses.
Oh.
No, but that's kind of stupid, though. Could you imagine, like, the Johnsons do good parties every year. This year I heard there's a rumor out there. No, I don't know if it's true or not. That they are bringing in a drag queen.
It's just the talk of the town.
Oh, yeah. Everyone wants to go to Tiffany's birthday party. She's got a man who chopped off his balls and now was dancing in front of children.
Yeah.
You're transphobic if you don't like that. I have better glasses. How is it?
Oh, these are way better.
Yeah, yeah. You won't know where I color. All right, what is the next topic? Oh, yeah, trans people and abortion. Could you imagine going all the way through high school, going through elementary school, middle school, high school, going to college, getting accepted into a college because you studied so hard, and then getting all your degrees, master's degree, then you get your doctorate degree, and then you go to medical school, all to go to a doctor's office, and then have to do a fake abortion on a trans person. Oh my gosh, so what you need to do is pretend you're giving birth, and I'll pretend to pull the baby out and kill it.
Why do I feel like that would be just the weirdest?
Can you smear the pretend blood on my face?
That would just
if
be the
you
weirdest.
Want to.
That would be so weird. And let me just tell you, those trans people probably aren't the greatest actors, so... You're gonna walk into the room, they're...
Oh my gosh! It's a boy! I mean, non-binary! That was my giving birth impression.
That wouldn't be pretty, though.
No, that wouldn't. Can you imagine, though, like, lifting up the dress? Oh my gosh, there's still testicles!
There's like one hanging out!
Oh, my eyes! I just exposed my eyes for a second.
No!
I hit my glasses.
It's alright. We have the blur.
I cringed so hard, I hit my glasses off. I was like, boom.
That's why when we start doing lives, we gotta be more self-conscious.
No, we need to, like, hot glue by each
other. Yeah,
and
just
dab.
Like, we'll be wearing glasses for the rest of our lives just because of this YouTube channel.
You're welcome. That's why you need already, if you haven't already, click that subscribe button. Give it a thumbs up. You probably haven't made it this far into the video, though.
Yeah, definitely not.
Why'd they kill my mood?
Right as it left your mouth, you're like, nope.
No, but that's so stupid. Like,
what's... That's so dumb. I just don't understand. It's so, like, when you take something and you change it, you're gonna lose a right. Like, no one can... I feel like no one has perfectly equal, like, things. Like, everyone is gonna have equal rights, but, like... Men are stronger, they're naturally stronger than women. And the same thing with, like, how women give birth. You can't just change it and expect magically you'd be able to do the exact same thing.
Oh, I got why. I woke up this morning and had Ace Ventura hair. In the movie Ace Ventura, he kisses a man who's pretending to be a woman.
Oh.
And he goes in the bathroom and is like, oh! Like, in the sink and barfing in the toilet. This episode, that was destiny. That was destiny right there.
No, this was...
Alrighty then!
This was definitely planned. This was planned.
No, that was meant to happen. What was that? I think I was trying to pray for a second. Like, thank you very much. Thank you very much for making me support in a transgender joke.
Thank you,
as
God.
As we see a hand come out of the clouds. Yes.
Yes. You are doing... Jesus, you are doing the Lord's work.
You are my favorite son next to Jesus. Alright, should I review the documentary What is a Woman?
Oh yeah.
Alright, so the documentary What is a Woman was released by Matt Walsh, actually at the beginning of Pride Month, as
I want to watch this movie so bad! It makes me so mad that I haven't watched it yet.
Alright, it's on the Daily Wire, like, I don't know, maybe we could get you it.
Yes.
The memberships on the Daily Wire, though, were like $14, like, a month.
Holy.
But I'm canceling it right after this month.
It's worth it.
I'm sorry, Daily Wire, I'm poor. I'd watch it if I wasn't poor. That's why you need to click the subscribe button.
And then we can watch more of...
Ben. What a legend. Freaking Ben. He also does the series Ben. Debunked. Have you seen that trailer for that series?
For what? Debunked?
Yeah, have you seen that?
Yeah.
Where it, like, shows everyone in, like, their room, and the one person's like, rich people haven't paid their
money. Oh, yeah.
And then Ben Shapiro walks in, like, it's a scene. It's a scene you've already seen. You know? You have a liberal friend over, like for subjecting you to his liberal beliefs. You don't suffer through this. He watch the series debunked, and then, like, the person's all like, well, actually, the rich pay 40% of their taxes, and then Ben Shapiro's like, well, then.
Yes.
Dude, that gave me so much motivation, though. Like, even though I didn't pay for the series, I saw him go, well done. And I was
Yeah! Just gives you, it almost gives you as much motivation from the Independence Day speech.
Oh, yeah, that's a close second. That and the Braveheart speech.
Yes.
All right, but the Matt Walsh documentary, What is a Woman? He dives into the topic. Like, he literally goes around the world, like, around the U.S. and even to Africa in one scene, to go around and ask different people, what is a woman? So he asks, like, gender studies professors. He asks, like, famous, like, people, like, congressmen.
The living legend, the Star Wars shop owner.
Oh, that guy. Dude, that guy gotta adopt me.
We want him to be our grandpa.
I gotta get a hold of that guy and, like, get him as a caller on the show.
That would be our first caller, that dude, legend.
I gotta get him on the show. We gotta try.
We need to. What even is his name?
I don't know. We gotta
We'll just call him the Star Wars guy.
Dude, he is the Star Wars old man. That is the man, the myth, the legend right there. I haven't seen a cooler guy out there.
He doesn't give two craps.
No, we gotta get him on the show. Dude, I'm actually gonna work for that, honestly.
Yeah.
I'm gonna try and locate him
and reach him
on, like, Twitter or Facebook.
Where did he do the documentary at?
At a shop. In What is a Woman. But that guy's in What is a Woman. That's why you should watch it. Because personally, after I finished that film, he interviews a woman who turned into a man, right?
Yeah.
And that person regrets their transition so hard.
Really?
They're like, this person's like, there are 5 children's hospitals in the U.S. promoting this, and she rolls down her arm, and there's, like, veins bulging and, like, bruises everywhere because of the transition surgery and the hormones.
Oh.
There's actually a direct link in those hormones to cancer.
Are you
like
serious?
Those hormones they inject in little kids are linked to cancer.
And they're not talking about that crap, but they don't care about abortion.
So at the transgender party, you know, they have the transgender person dancing. They're like, all right, what is your present? They open it and there's hormones. Oh my gosh! What the heck is that?
It's like the Jack in the Box.
Hormones! A needle just pops up.
Mommy, I don't want to be a girl.
You're bad. Non-binary child.
Boom.
They shot him with hormones.
And forget a tranquilizer dart. The way to screw up someone's life is shooting with a hormone dart. Ah!
Did you hit your knee on that?
All right, guys, we're back.
Hey! Welcome back to the Proud Show. Here, I'm going to turn back. I'm going to turn back into a man.
Oh, hey, welcome back to the Proud Show, everybody.
Anyway.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, that was a Thug Life joke right there.
Oh, my grab glasses. Now we're sponsored by Minecraft.
Alright, but I think this is the most important documentary. It has actually been the most talked about film in the U.S. right now.
What is a Woman?
I have traveled all over the world for the past year asking one simple question. What is a woman? What is a woman?
What is it?
What is it?
I don't know.
People are laughing. Is that a dumb question?
I've been asking everybody this, and almost nobody can answer it.
What is a woman?
What is a woman?
That's a great question.
If one person could tell me what a woman is.
Congressman, thank you for being here.
I think this interview is over. Let's turn off the cameras.
I just wanted to know, what is a woman?
And you're not going to find out.
It's not a complicated question.
Matt Walsh has actually received threats to get hit in the head with a baseball bat. I saw one this morning where someone was like, I hope Matt Walsh gets food poisoning, which that's pretty vile. If you've had food poisoning,
poisoning sucks.
That person went too far. They deserve to have food poisoning. That person clearly has never had food poisoning if they're wishing that on another human being.
And the funny thing is if people start getting this crazy and worked up about something, that just shows that they know they lost.
Alright, but that is like a 97% audience rating.
That's good.
That is freaking
fantastic. Rotten Tomatoes wouldn't even review it.
All right, but that is the most important film I've ever seen, I think. Yeah. I think everyone in America should see it.
Jack. I love those girls at, like, the very start of the trailer.
Oh, they were at the women's rights protest, and he's like,
what is a woman?
He's like, what is a woman?
And they're like, you know, they start laughing.
That's the Matt Walsh voice. What is a woman?
What is a woman?
And they're like, that deep voice.
And he's like, then why are you here? And then they just walk away.
I know. Trans women are women. What is that? But honestly, that is the most important film I've ever seen. That is probably 9.5 stars out of 10. I really liked it. Except there's one part with this, like, naked old man. They cut the screen off, though, just there.
Oh,
that made me uncomfortable. And he's like, the guy's like, yeah. He's like, does this affect you anyway? He's like, no, my daughters are like 20 years old and they're completely fine. I'm like, yeah, I bet the heck they are.
Oh, my.
That was disgusting.
That's
anyway.
Gross. We should talk about that book.
Oh, Johnny the Walrus?
That book is so funny.
The best-selling LGBTQ book ever. Matt Walsh needs... He actually has won awards for it.
Wait, Matt Walsh wrote that one, too?
Yeah, he wrote that book, too. Dude, he's the best when it comes to, like, gender debunking. Like, his other stuff is okay, but his gender debunking stuff is...
spot on.
Dude, we need to watch his Dr. Phil episode one day.
Is he, like... talking to Dr. Phil or just like...
He's on Dr. Phil's show and there's a transgender person with him and he brings up some of the best points I've ever heard. Like, he's like, you can't tell me to do preferred pronouns. That's like me telling to do adjectives. Like, my adjectives are brilliant and handsome and you have to call me by that.
Yeah.
And then he's like, someone could die 100 years ago. Let's say that. You dig up the bones today and you can still see what gender they were because it's down to the bone. But you have no idea what they thought because that does not matter the moment they died. Like, that's all gone.
Yeah.
Like, their thoughts... are way different from biology, right?
And why is, like, mispronouncing people the most, like, demonic thing in the world now?
Dude, if mispronouncing people is the most demonic thing, that old man is Satan.
Yeah, and he's a good one.
Dude, he's a handsome devil.
He's a heck of a good Satan.
That guy, his glasses, too. I need those. I would wear those, show my eyes.
We should just totally one episode when if we can
should
get
we do
him
a Star
on
Wars
call.
Should we do a Star Wars themed episode?
To, like, catch his attention.
I gotta get a hold of that guy.
That would be so funny. And then we could, like, dress up as him.
Oh.
And then call him.
I gotta get, like,
Star Wars stuff in the bag.
Dude, we could change our background to Star Wars stuff.
Yes. Put, like, a Darth Vader mask on Ben.
Dude, I'd have to add a lot of bleep sound effects, but it'd be good.
Yeah. It's like, I don't give a...
Dude, if we got that guy on the call, that'd be the most important episode ever.
Oh my goodness.
Dude, that guy's so good.
That would be amazing. And that could maybe even start us off.
Alright, what is the last thing we have on the list?
Oh, the last thing...
I think it was the What is a Woman review. I think there was another one.
Trans surgeries.
Oh, transgender surgeries?
The hormone treatment.
Yeah, I think I already brought this up in the What is a Woman review. But trans surgeries, there's a 67% chance success rate.
Of it working.
Yeah, and they are advertising this to children. And the people that he interviewed in What is a Woman, the trans people, they actually said they didn't get a run through what is it called?
Side effects,
yeah. That's the word. They before the surgery, they didn't even get a rundown of the side effects.
Isn't that illegal?
Because people, they make it so hard to sue trans people. Because if you sue them, you're transphobic, obviously.
Yeah.
You get canceled.
I thought that was illegal. Because in all, like, the
pill commercials. Well, the person claimed they didn't get a rundown.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, you think of a parent telling a kid, though, you need to get a transgender surgery, son. You need to become a woman. Okay. Is there any side effects? Not that I know of. You think you think a parent who's scoring for points on media is gonna run down their kids on how bad transgender surgeries are? Not a chance.
And I saw this thing. It's so sad that I think it was on Steven Crowder's new episode where they were talking about how kids. All they want to do is please their parents.
That's true.
They only want to look, and if their parents are filling them with this crap...
You gotta cut off your bell, son.
Then
he doesn't
love
you anymore.
They're like, okay.
Daddy won't love you anymore if you don't chop off your balls.
5 minutes later, they're just like on the floor.
Daddy, no, you can't! You have to love me! No, I won't, son. Unless you do the surgery.
Only if you're a girl.
Unless you go into full-on surgery and let them inject friendly chemicals into you, and then I'll love you. Okay. If it pleases you. All right. So let's just wrap this episode up. I think that this country, a while ago, though, was saying, like, trans kids were not being indoctrinated. You guys are freaking liars for saying that, right?
Yeah.
They were saying that stuff a long time ago. But look at it now. They're literally taking them into strip clubs to watch people show their culture. And, like, as we watched a video earlier, this woman claimed that it was culture. But it's the same thing as a Chinese woman shaking her butt at kids. It's the same thing as a Chinese man shaking his butt at kids. It's the same as a Latino, black, I don't give a frick. They're still shaking their freaking butt at kids, and it's wrong. But they're masking it up because they're trans.
Yeah, in that same video, before she said that, she also said, she said, like, she has done, like, plays, like, yeah. Frozen and something. And that's fine.
I don't care. Go along with your life, but don't
start stripping and shaking your butt at a child.
No, it's morally bad. Evil is still evil, whether they're trans or not. A trans person can be good. I made friends with trans people. I know some gay people. I don't hate them. But their values are different. I don't hate them still about their values, even though I disagree with some of them, right?
Yeah.
But when you rope kids into this and still do things that would be considered evil if anyone else did it and are trying to mask it up because it's your culture, you got another thing coming. You are an idiot if you believe that.
Yeah, and a lot of times the reasons why, like, the people that I do enjoy being around that are trans or, like, have a different gender, it's because they don't force it upon me.
Yeah.
To always learn about it. They have their idea, I have mine. We don't talk about it all the time.
But it's like the same thing whenever a kid goes, I'm homeschooled, by the way. That pisses me off.
That's the
still
same thing.
Annoying is still annoying. And when a trans person comes up and is like, I'm trans, by the way, it's like,
oh, so should I give you everything?
Oh, so what do you want me to do? Give you a raise? Take your crap and leave. I don't work here. I don't care. But, like, it's stupid. It's evil is still evil. That's the moral of today's story.
Yes. Evil is still evil.
Right? This is the Proud Show. We are checking out. Oh, wait. We'll try and get a hold of that Star Wars guy from now on. And next time Joe Biden gives a speech, we will be shot with airsoft guns. I did a little burp during that one. We will be shot with airsoft guns every time he stutters.
Oh, this one is going to be bad.
That would be funny, though.
Guys, I'm going to
That's like Gandhi, like, starving himself. We're doing the same thing. We're basically Gandhi.
I'm going to have to explain to my parents why I have welts all over my body.
Square jeans.
Yeah. Well.
Peace out.
This is us signing off.
The Proud Show. Whoa. You just got me.
Sunshine. Joe Brandon, I agree. Clouds rain. Train whistles blow and guitars play. Farmers plow, wishes go.